Va'Etchanan, one of the saddest moments of Jewish history. This beautiful portion that contains the Ten Commandments and contains Shema Yisrael begins with a personal prayer of Moses. Va'Etchanan el Adonai ba'etahi lemor. And I beseeched the Lord at that time, saying. And Moses prays, a perfect kind of prayer. He begins with praise to God. Ata chilota laharot et avdecha et kodlecha v'et yodcha chazaka. You began to show your servant your greatness and your strong arm. Who is like the Almighty in heaven on earth? Who can do like your deeds, like your great acts? And after Shevach, after praising God, as we do as well in the Amida, comes the request. Ebra na ve'er'e et ha'aretz ha'tuva asher be'ever hayadein. Let me pass, please, so that I may see the good land which is on the other side of the Jordan. He just wants to see. He just wants to pass through. And God doesn't allow him to do it. It's very difficult to understand. Moses, a leader who gave up so much, gave up the Egyptian palace, gave up any kind of personal life with wife and children, in order to serve God and in order to serve the Jewish people. But this is also very significant. Many years ago, while sitting in a dentist's chair, I read a fascinating vignette in the Reader's Digest. A young girl, 5 years old perhaps, was sent by her mother, who was not at all a religious woman, to a Catholic nursery school. It was convenient, it was right near the house. And strangely enough, or perhaps understandably enough, the child became very much enamored of the religious Catholic way of life. And she began to pray every morning. And she would play God with her dolls. And she had a favorite doll. And one afternoon, the mother found the girl home from nursery, crying her heart out. On the floor was the doll, but with a severed head. Apparently, a bicycle had rammed into the doll in the doll carriage, and the head of the doll was severed from the body. And the young girl was crying disconsolately. She couldn't be comforted. And she was begging God to please put the doll's head back on its body. The mother watched with mild amusement, and the next day could not control herself and said to her daughter, "It doesn't look like God heard your prayers at all." And the child looked up, perplexed, and said, "What do you mean? Of course God heard my prayers." But, said the mother, "The doll's head is still severed from its body." To which the young girl responded, "But that doesn't mean that God didn't hear my prayers. Of course he did. He just said no." Very often, when we pray to God, we feel that he has to say yes. And if he doesn't say yes, that means he didn't hear our prayers, he didn't respond to our prayers. The Bible is teaching us that even someone as great as Moses, when we pray to him, we must always remember that he reserves the right to say no. The fact that he didn't answer in the affirmative is no reason to reject him or even to think that he didn't hear the prayer. We must always approach God with a certain sense of humility and modesty. A very wise man once said, "Beware of what you pray for, because you might get it in the end, and it may be the worst thing for you." Whenever we pray, we must be ready for God to say no as well. Shabbat Shalom.